Today on Two Crazy Ketos, we got mail.
And we'll find out what's inside right after this. Hey, what's up, family? I'm Rachel.
And I'm Joe.
And we are Two Crazy Ketos.
If you're new to our channel, welcome. Here on Two Crazy Ketos, we do different things like product reviews, we do recipe videos, we talk about various keto topics, and then every Monday, we sit down on the couch for Keto on the Couch. We just kind of talk about what's going on in our lives for the week.
You can find us on different social media platforms like Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter.
And we have a website, which is twocrazyketos.com, and that's where you're going to find all of our different recipes. Now, we do upload at least 5 new videos every single week, so make sure you subscribe to our channel.
And don't forget to hit the little bell icon, and that way, every single time we upload a new video, you'll be alerted to it.
Yeah. So we got mail today.
What's in the mail today? What's in the mail today?
I love it. It says it's fragile. Please handle with care and freeze it upon arrival.
Maybe it's a head.
That'd be cool.
It's a severed head.
I'm sorry, Jason. I'm using my razor blade still because I love the letter opener. It works great on my letters, but it doesn't work so well on like shipping tape.
Tape.
Okay. I'm pretty sure I know what this is. Yep, it is what it is. It is what I thought it is. It is...
cake!
Cake. It's actually 2 new kinds of cake, and I'm really excited about these.
From Smart Cake.
Yeah, so Smart Cakes came out with 2 new cakes, and they also discontinued my favorite one.
No.
Yeah.
Which one?
The orange cream.
Oh, okay. That wasn't my favorite one. Oh, phew! As long as cinnamon's still safe.
Or they, I don't know if discontinued, they retired it, so. Okay, so we have 2 products. We have their Smart Muffins, okay? And there's 3 in here, but I think they're really big.
Okay.
And this one is going to be just for you because...
Vanilla Latte.
These are Vanilla Latte, and I believe these have caffeine in them.
No, they don't.
Yeah, I believe they do, if I remember right, seeing on their website.
Are you serious?
I will have to double check, but yeah. So yeah, they're beyond gluten-free. So we're going to try these.
Yeah.
Okay, so... if you're new to our channel, we review all products based on 5 things. We talk about the ingredients, a nutrition label, does it keto based on nutrition, how does it taste, how much does it cost, and finally, would we recommend it? So we're going to change things up. In the past, we've kind of like opened it up, gone over through everything, eaten them, then talked about the 5 things. What we're going to start doing to maybe shorten the videos just a little bit is go through the 5 things right from the very beginning. We're going to start off with tasting it.
Well, but we're not getting rid of the high five, though.
No, we're not getting rid of the high five. So we're going to put this through our high five review. So we're going to start off with tasting it, and then we will go through the nutrition and everything as we go through the 5 things.
Because I can't wait to taste it.
Okay, so which one do we want to try first?
I don't know.
Well, I'm just taking them out of the box right now. So, ooh, look at
Whoa, look at the size of that bad boy.
Look at that. Okay, so we'll put these up to the side. So this one here is the Vanilla Latte Smart Cakes.
I'm kind of excited about a new flavor. Of course, is it going to touch cinnamon? I mean, is it going to get better than cinnamon for me? I love that cinnamon.
Since we're going to have both cakes, I'm just going to use my knife.
I was going to say, do you need help?
Since we're going to have both cakes, we're only going to split them. So that is the Vanilla Latte.
I gotta smell it.
So if you've never had Smart Cakes before, we love these things. It's just a nice little dessert, and they're extremely low in calories.
They're like a magical unicorn, because how can something be this good and this low in calories and carbs?
Listen to that. Can you guys hear that? I hope you can hear that.
They're super moist. I said
moist.
It.
Moist.
This tastes very fall, right?
It almost tastes like a pumpkin spice.
It does. That's what I'm saying. It's like it's a fall taste.
That's pretty good.
That's good. I don't know if I'm tasting like
I don't taste Vanilla Latte,
coffee.
Though. It's really good, but I don't taste Vanilla Latte.
It does. It tastes more like a pumpkin spice. But, I mean, I guess there's no pumpkin spice in it, but.
I could have sworn I saw something about caffeine, but there is nothing on the package about it. So sorry about that, guys.
Drink it with the coffee.
Drink it with the coffee.
Okay. I always eat it bottom to top. The little dusting on the top tastes more. That's the most amount of coffee Vanilla Latte taste.
Ooh. Part left in there.
That was good. But it tastes like fall.
Yeah. It's to me, it's a little vanilla-y, but it's also kind of got like a pumpkin spice kind of thing to it.
Yeah, it does.
Sorry. Okay, let's move on to the chocolate chip muffins. And since we've never had these before, let's just see what these are. These are breakfast beyond gluten-free smart muffins. This is a completely new product.
They look amazing.
No copy on the box or anything like that. So we'll go over the ingredients with our five things. Okay? Let's not eat this whole thing.
Wow, that looks... That's very tempting, though.
Yeah, look at that.
That looks amazing.
Should we break it in half and... Yeah. We'll break it in half and then we'll eat half and then save the other half for later. Ooh.
That's a lot of chocolate chips. Wow.
We'll eat that later.
Okay. You mean I'll eat that later.
Okay.
So this is supposed to be a breakfast muffin.
Ooh, chocolate chip on the floor.
Oh my gosh, it's very chocolatey.
Oh my gosh, it smells like chocolate chips.
Wow. That's really good.
Oh my gosh. This one's got to be bad for you.
This is too good.
That is like good.
I really want to heat it up a little bit.
Yeah, I know, but...
I want to warm it. I would totally warm this.
I would absolutely warm it normally.
And let the chocolate get all gooey.
The chocolate chips are kind of falling off on me. That is good.
The cake is very light, just like vanilla.
It is like a light, I mean, that is very similar to like non-keto muffins. It doesn't have the same texture as the smart cakes. It's not as spongy.
Man, is there something wrong with it? Because that was really good.
Okay, so you want to put this through the five things now?
Yes.
So we'll do five things again. Five things. Which one are we starting with?
You have cake on your finger.
Not anymore.
Let's do this.
Let's start with this because we've done the other ones before.
I'm really kind
of
concerned.
Why don't we refresh everybody's memory on that one because we don't have to go through a whole lot with this. So, the cakes that we just had, one of these cakes, 38 calories, it is 2.5 grams of fat, 9 grams of carbohydrates total, 5 grams of fiber, 4 grams of erythritol. So, 0 net carbs.
That makes me so happy.
And 4 grams of protein. The ingredients in these are eggs, purified water, proprietary fiber blend, which is oat fiber, corn fiber, and flax, erythritol, whey protein isolate, olive oil, pure vanilla, cinnamon, ground coffee, salt, cellulose gum, monk fruit, citric acid, spices, and herbs.
So it's got ground coffee in it. I taste it on the top. Yeah. I taste it on the top.
You know what's one thing that you don't see in their products?
What?
Natural flavors.
Man, I can't even make a face.
Yeah, no natural flavors in here. So yeah, we really like these, but this is one of the things that people ask, like, how can you, why do you follow total carbs or why do you put a limit on your total carbs for the day? Because with these, I could easily turn like 100 total carbs into 0 net carbs.
I could eat this entire box.
Think about it. If you eat 10 of these.
Which I could.
Okay, you'd only be eating 380 calories. You'd be eating what is that, 90 total carbs, but 0 net carbs.
See?
That's not good for you.
You don't want math equations to work in my favor.
Okay, so that was a refresh from memory on those.
But we have given these to, like, kids.
Oh, yeah.
I mean...
We bring them to kids at church all the time that are gluten-free, and they love them.
They're really good.
Okay, so we're going to go over these since we haven't had these before. So let's see the ingredients. Purified water, eggs, proprietary fiber blend, which is oat fiber, corn fiber, and flax. Erythritol, whey protein isolate, unsweetened chocolate, cocoa butter,
it's
olive
not
oil.
Sweet. They stay sweet.
Sunflower lecithin, salt, potassium chloride, cellulose gum, monk fruit, citric acid, spices, herbs, cocoa powder, stevia extract.
No, oh, okay, so you've got stevia and monk fruit. That's why it's, I mean, it tastes nice and sweet.
Yeah, but that is good. Yeah. They're great ingredients. I mean, if you're going to complain about anything, people sometimes complain about the proprietary fiber blend because it's got oat and corn fiber, but it's the fibers. It's not, you're not eating the grains itself.
No.
Okay? So, calories.
One
muffin, 90 calories.
That is
in the whole muffin.
Huge muffin.
6 grams of fat, 9 grams of protein, 18 total carbohydrates, 12 grams of dietary fiber, 6 grams of erythritol. 0 net carbs.
Wow.
They are playing some magic with, like, non-chemical ingredients.
Because I could eat that entire box. That yeah. is, that's, I mean, you figure, okay, so this was, this is still only 45 calories.
Yeah.
What you and I ate, half of 45 calories.
Yes, and we ate, what, 22 and a half calories?
Are you kidding? Did you see how giant that piece was?
That was big. Okay, so that is the ingredients. And so I would say, like I said, our five things. Sorry, this is the first time we're doing this. So it's a little screwed up.
We're a little clunky.
Right? So number one is ingredients. The ingredients are really good.
Yeah.
Right? Number two, does it keto based on the nutrition facts?
Heck yes.
Yeah. So again, 90 calories, 6 grams of fat, 9 grams of protein. I mean, zero net carbs.
I mean, do you want to eat 4 of these in a day? Even if you're a net carb person, probably not.
No.
Like, I mean, you shouldn't eat 4 of desserty tasting things.
Right.
I don't think. I mean, you need to have like your real food. You need some steak, some bacon, and things like that.
No, they are 18 total carbs. So if you're a total carb person, you're really gonna have to watch yourself.
Okay. But
it's a nice treat, and that's what we use it for. We eat them once in a while. We don't eat one every day. We eat one maybe once or twice a week. Like, hey, I want something little. I don't want to overdo our fat. I don't want to overdo our carbs. I don't want to overdo our calories.
But if you want a giant portion without feeling guilty, like
90 calories. Okay, so number three, how do they taste?
They taste really good.
They taste really good. Like, you're
like, is this okay to eat? Because it's really that good.
Now, the vanilla latte ones, again, I think the coffee is so mild, it almost comes across as like a fally pumpkin spice.
Yeah.
There's obviously no pumpkin spice in there, but it is very, very mild.
Yeah. So if you are going to purchase this one hoping for a real like coffee taste,
it
doesn't have it.
But then again, vanilla lattes don't have a coffee taste, right? They're like mostly milk and sugar.
Yeah. And that tastes very milky and sugary.
Okay. So now with this one, I'm not exaggerating. I think this one is as close to a non-keto muffin that I have had to date.
But I would warm it.
Absolutely.
I would definitely warm it because the muffin is not like super buttery or I don't know. It's very
mild, light, airy muffin.
But I think it's designed that way so that the chocolate gets to take over.
Now, in our defense, we did. It came in the mail early this morning. And we stuck it in the freezer. And so it's been sitting. I just literally pulled it out of the freezer and we're eating it. So it probably could have been warmed up a little bit anyway.
I think that would make it taste magical.
Yeah. So number four, how much do they cost?
All right.
Okay.
Bring it.
So we're going to start with the muffins. The cupcakes. The cupcakes, you can buy them on their website. I'll leave a link down below. We also have a coupon code, which is 2CrazyKetos. That'll get you 10% off. They also, on a regular basis, have sales. If you go to their website, sign up for their mailing list, they just finished like a 20% off sale. It may even still be going on if you're checking out this video today, but they have sales almost on a weekly basis. And so even if you follow our link, you still get the sale prices.
Yeah,
okay,
it's good.
So you can buy them two ways. You can buy them in an 8-pack where you get 4 of these and there's 8 muffins.
Uh-huh.
That's going to cost you $15. It's about $1.88 per cupcake.
But they are so stinking good.
Or you can buy them, and this is the way I recommend anybody buy them. You can buy them in a pack of 8, which is 16.
This box.
This box is how many in there? That's the 8 box,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, it's 8.
So it's this box, and that would give you 16 total cupcakes. And again, we only eat one when we eat them, when we save the other one.
Yeah.
And that would be $28 for $1.75. Now, in addition to that, once you've placed an order with them, you get put into like their special club.
Mm-hmm.
You get a little bit of a discount and you also get cheaper shipping.
And I mean, these are so great for parties. We've brought them with us to like different functions where it's like a potluck, bring a dessert. And nobody is laughing about like a keto dessert.
Right.
I mean, these are really good. Everyone enjoys them.
Okay, so now let's go over the price on this one. So these are $9. It looks like, yep, $9 for this box.
Okay.
It's $8.95. And you get 3 muffins in it. So it's $3 a muffin.
But I think about, I just met a friend at Panera Bread for coffee. And Panera Bread.
Mm-hmm.
Like, it's expensive. It's way more than $3 for a muffin. And it's not that big.
I was going to look. There's nothing on here. It doesn't say how much does one weigh. 62 grams. And how much does one of these weigh? 30 grams. So basically one of these is equal to two of these.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a pretty much the same calories, 38 calories or night for
it's
one.
It's denser, 90. I feel like.
I'm more satisfied with this one.
Yeah, this one.
I would, even if you only eat half like we are and then putting the other half
it feels
away,
like a meal more.
It's also a little bit cheaper because this is going to work out to be $1.75 for two, for each of them. So that's $3.50 for two or $3 for one.
Plus bigger portion.
Plus a little bit bigger portion. Okay, so number five, would we recommend these?
Yeah, we love them. I mean, we get a lot of cookies. We get a lot of muffins. You know, I don't think we've had muffins, honestly. But we've had a lot of, like, different dessert things that people have sent. This is by far, like, our favorite,
I think it's one of the few things that we actually buy on a regular basis. I mean, just I have constantly. A freezer full. I just like having them so that we have a go-to thing. Again, we don't eat them all the time.
No.
But we have them in the freezer if we have company come over, if we have kids who come over who are gluten-free.
Or if we just have a little bit of leeway left in our macros for the day and you just want something sweet and not and you don't want to, like, you know, bomb yourself, that this is the great way to go.
Now, the one thing, a lot of people ask us all the time about why do keto products cost so much money? It's because when you look at the ingredients, okay,
it's
and
quality.
There's no preservatives in this stuff. So it's like not super shelf stable to just leave out on your counter. I mean, there are Best Buy dates on here, but my suggestion, if you get smart cakes, stick them in your freezer or at least your refrigerator.
Yeah.
Don't leave them on your counter regardless of what the date is on here because there's nothing in here to act as a preservative.
No, which is awesome, actually, because you're not eating all those chemicals that are garbage.
Yeah, so if you order them, get them, put them in your refrigerator, put them in a freezer, and that's the best place to store them. And then when you take them out, all you do is leave them on the counter for like 5 minutes or stick them in the microwave for like 20 seconds, and they're perfect to eat.
Unless you have children, in which case you will want to hide them on a counter that they can't get to. Because if they see them laying on the counter, they're
going
to eat
them. So that is our video for today. Let us know down in the comments section if you've ever tried smart cakes and what your favorite flavor is.
Cinnamon.
Mine was orange cream. Now it's raspberry cream. Or, I don't know, now it might be these.
Now it's the muffin.
Yeah. They also have great hamburger buns.
Oh, yes, they do.
Yeah, so they're called smart buns. And if you're missing a bun with your burger and you want an occasional one, they're awesome. I'll leave a link down below.
We love those.
So like we said, that is our video for today. Please do us a favor and hit that like button down below.
And don't forget to subscribe to our channel and hit the little bell icon. And that way, every single time we upload a new video, you'll be alerted to it.
Until next time.
Bye.